Hello friends, now we see the derivative of trigonometric function with proof. The number 5 is fx is equal to sec x. Now let's see the proof. So first we start with fx is equal to sec x. Therefore the next step is f of x plus h is equal to sec in bracket x plus h. Then by first principle of derivative, we have f dash x is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus fx whole thing divided by h, that equal to limit h tends to 0. Now for f of x plus h we substitute sec of x plus h minus, for fx we write sec x, and then whole thing divided by h. So that equal to limit h tends to 0. Now here sec theta, we apply trigo formula that 1 upon cos theta. And therefore sec of x plus h can be written as 1 upon cos x plus h minus, for sec x, we write 1 upon cos x, and then whole thing divided by h, we write as it is. The next step will be, here we will go for cross multiply. So on cross multiplying, we get limit h tends to 0 cos of x minus cos of x plus h upon cos of x plus h into cos x into h. Now in the numerator we apply formula cos c minus cos d. That equal to minus 2 sine in bracket c plus d upon 2 into sine in bracket c minus d upon 2. So in present case c represent x and d represent x plus h. So the next step will be limit h tends to 0 minus 2 sine in bracket x plus h upon 2 into sine in bracket x minus h upon 2 and then totally divide by cos of x plus h into cos x into h. So that equal to limit h tends to 0 minus 2 into sine in bracket. Now x plus x we get 2x plus h upon 2 into sine in bracket. Here plus 6 minus 6 we cancel. So we left with minus h upon 2 bracket complete. And then whole thing divided by cos of x plus h into cos x into h. The next step will be limit h tends to 0 minus 2 into sine of 2x plus h upon 2, we write as it is. Again, here we use trigo formula that sine of minus theta gives minus sine theta. So here we get minus sine of h by 2. And whole thing divided by cos of x plus h into cos x into h. Is equal to limit h tends to 0. Now minus minus we get plus. So that plus 2 we write outside the limit. So 2 into limit h tends to 0 sine of 2x plus h upon 2 bracket complete into limit h tends to 0 sine of h by 2 upon h by 2 and into 1 by 2. Then totally divide by limit h tends to 0 cos of x plus h into cos x. Now 2 we write as it is into sine in bracket whenever h we put 0. So we have 2x plus 0 upon 2 into then limit h tends to 0 sine of h by 2 upon h by 2. So that gives 1 into 1 by 2 totally divided by cos in bracket x plus 0 into cos x. Now here we cancel 2 from numerator and denominator. Also inside the bracket we cancel 2 from numerator denominator. So in the numerator we left with sin x and in the denominator we left with cos x into cos x. So this can be written as 1 upon cos x into sin x upon cos x. Now 1 upon cos x gives sec x and sin upon cos x gives tan x. So in this way we get f dash x is equal to sec x into tan x. So thus we proved the derivative of sec x is sec x tan x. Thank you.